Mesdames et messieurs, bienvenue, welcome back. Notre prochain orateur gère les partenariats internationaux dans le secteur de commerce de gros chez HEMA. Donc HEMA, vous connaissez peut-être, c'est un détaillant de marchandises variées basé à Amsterdam, réputé pour ses produits de haute qualité à des prix raisonnables. Donc dans ce keynote qui sera en anglais, comme je l'ai précisé tout à l'heure, donc si vous avez besoin de casques, n'hésitez pas, il y en a à l'entrée. Donc vous pourrez suivre le parcours de HEMA qui vient de faire ses premiers pas à Paris en proposant une solution complète non alimentaire chez Franprix. Donc, je le disais, donc, our next keynote speaker is Managing International Wholesale Partnerships at HEMA. HEMA is a general merchandise retailer from Amsterdam, known for its optimistic design and high-quality products at affordable prices. So in this keynote, you can follow actually the journey of HEMA, which has just taken its first step here in Paris, offering a one-stop shop, non-food solution to Franprix. And for that, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased to welcome on stage the International Wholesale Director at HEMA, Olivier Blum.
Merci, Asha, pour cette fantastique introduction. Je m'appelle Olivier Blum, je travaille chez HEMA et je suis responsable pour le partenariat grossiste. Je suis très fier d'être ici à Paris aujourd'hui parce qu'il y en a juste 2 semaines qu'on a lancé un fantastique concept à Paris. Je continue cette présentation en anglais parce que ça, c'est plus facile pour moi. So the subject is from a Dutch retailer to a global brand. And is this the clicker? Yeah, is it? Okay, great. So does anybody recognize some of these brands? I have to say they're all from the Netherlands. Anybody, what's in common here? Are these all fantastic best practices, something that we can be proud of, something that I can tell you something about? Actually, it's not. All these brands have gone bankrupt since 2015. So it just could not cope with the changing retail landscape. And some have been rebrought to life. But it's definitely that retail is at the crossroads these days. So these companies took the wrong exit. But today, I will tell you about the journey of HEMA. So how we face this crossroads. Which exit do we take? The left, the right, or just continue the road? It's a journey that's all about new business models. So I hope that will be exciting to see some new ways how we approach retail. And it's also about entrepreneurship and change. So feel free to interact with me afterwards with the help of Asha. And perhaps you face similar challenges in retail that we can talk about. But first, something about my journey. I'm from Amsterdam, and it's a city I'm proud of, but I like to travel. I like to go globally to see how other people live their life, but also to do business and see how we can create new things in an international environment. I worked before at another brand from Amsterdam, which is Heineken. It's a brand from 1864 and has also a special relationship here with Paris because in 1898 it has been crowned with the Grand Prix de Paris de Qualité. It's a historical milestone for this brand. Heineken went already in the 30s international, starting off in Asia, and is currently number 2 brewer in the world. This year I joined in 2019 at HEMA, also proudly from Amsterdam, but basically relatively shortly went on a similar growth path to become a global brand. HEMA started off in Amsterdam in 1926 and was a store of its kind, the first one that was a dollar store in Amsterdam. So we call it in Dutch eenheidsprijs, so all the items had clear price levels. And the philosophy was
to offer products also for people with small wallets in good quality. And that philosophy has not changed till date. So we grew in after we launched in 1926 to become a leading brand in the Netherlands with over 550 stores. And we're quite dominant in many categories. For example, we sell more clothes than H&M in the Netherlands. We expanded foremost in neighboring countries, currently have 770 stores. And last year, something special happened to us. We were taken over by Ramfastos. It's the investment vehicle of Marcel Boekhorn, a famous Dutch entrepreneur. And that started off the new journey. But first, let me show you something about our brand. So, our purpose, HEMA as a brand would like to democratize better living. We want to make the daily life better, easier, and more fun for everyone. That's for you as a customer, but that's also for society, and we take care of better things for the planet. So we use fair trade, we ensure proper labor conditions. We try to reduce the one-way plastic use, and we only sell bio cotton in our clothing. HEMA is social and inclusive, so we welcome also really all cultures and backgrounds, and irrespective of gender, sexual preference, religion, culture, body sizes. We're open-minded and have an optimistic view. And you see that also in our design. We design all our products ourselves, so that definitely differs us from any other retailer, and we design them all in Amsterdam. And it gives us a signature of HEMA, which is always colorful, fun, and optimistic. Here you see an example of a recent campaign where we emphasize on our responsible character. It says, it's in Dutch, it says, beautiful for today and good for tomorrow. And as of now, all our cotton is bio. So that's also resembled in the engagement on social media for our brand. So here you see our followers on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. And it's outperforming other retailers. So this is in France, the presence. And we just have 74 stores in France. That's all nice. Great. But I thought we were at the crossroads. So nice brand, but what is that new journey? What's the strategy that we are enrolling? Well, basically, our new strategy, our dot on the horizon, is to evolve from a retailer into a global lifestyle brand designed in Amsterdam. And we do not change our purpose. So that stays the same. Just the retail environment has, and we have to act on that. HEMA has a very wide assortment. So we basically sell all categories. That's very, very unusual. So our competitors are also wide. So it's from H&M to Zara, but also Flying Tiger. And some, actually also some food companies in the Netherlands are competing one-on-one with us. So all these other brands have gone global, and they have economies of scale and brand power. So we have to change as well. There is also an online retail that is growing fastly, and there's an explosion of new technologies. Customer journeys have changed. People just do not shop the same way as they did 10 years ago. So HEMA wants to enter the next phase to compete in that global omnichannel landscape. That means from local to really becoming global, from being known as a store brand to really become a global brand, selling not only products, but deeper into today's needs, and that's products and solutions. To place that, especially the second point, into perspective, many other brands have evolved from being actually a supplier or being a product brand into retailing as well. Lavazza was selling and producing and wholesaling coffee and opened up retail with espresso bars. And Levi's, after 130 years of just exclusively wholesaling, they opened up retail stores and their own flagship stores. Samsonite was just making suitcases and then opened up different categories and also opened up stores. So we actually, we moved the other way around. We come from a retail brand and we would like to become a global lifestyle brand. So now, what are those business models to unlock that growth? This is where we currently are, from a Dutch retail brand. As I said, we've owned stores, we have some franchise, and we have an online presence, hema.com. We evolved to a global multi-channel brand with four new business models. That is wholesale, master franchise, platforms, and partnerships. And I will explain them to you one by one. First, wholesale. And you already see the thing I'm proud of, why I'm here in Paris just 2 weeks ago. We launched a concept at Franprix, selling our products for the first time ever through the stores of another retailer. And that looks like this. Basically, we offer a non-stop shop, non-food solution for a food retailer. And actually, think a bit further, it can be also for other retailers that are not so well in non-food. We do this in a sort of a branded shop-in-shop environment where we sell things very close to food, convenient if you just forgot some glasses or your wine glasses are finished or broken, or you miss out some clothing, stationery, or you have a party at home to celebrate, and you buy all the food elements, but you want also to celebrate it really with some HEMA items. We do this in a co-branding way, so it's really a nice partnership where we use both brands to enforce each other. So outside and inside, you find a total merging almost of Franprix and HEMA. And luckily, those brands, also the values, they really are similar. They feel as colleagues from day one. So this movie shows you, this is a press movie, and it shows you what the partnership is. So what are the advantages of such a combination between HEMA as a non-food specialist and a food retailer? Why are we doing this? So we offer a complete one-stop shop non-food solution that delivers strong margins, better category management, premium shelf presentation, and going from many suppliers to one supplier also saves costs. HEMA has a very efficient distribution system where we are able, in blue crates, you maybe have seen it already in that previous movie, we are able in the blue crates to deliver exactly the right SKUs that are needed to replenish that shelf in that store. So there's no overstock, and there's also, we try to prevent with our planograms, no out of stocks. So that cost saving is also on further into logistics because we cross-dock. So there's no distribution space anymore needed for all those other five suppliers. And there's also no storage space needed. And when you're in Paris, we have over 600 stores, then you know the square meter price is very expensive. So it's a big saving. The next business model. It's master franchise. We open up new continents, actually, with HEMA by using the master franchise formula. Here you see a picture of the UAE. And that is HEMA in Arabic. And this is last week where we opened a new store in the EBN Boutata Mall. It's one of the largest malls in Dubai. By the end of this year, we have 10 stores, HEMA operating. And we're growing up to 50 in the Gulf region soon. But it's not only about the UAE. We try to open other continents. And actually, we look deeper into franchise concepts in the wider Europe area, also in France, maybe. Third business model, that is platforms. And I think it's a nice one, because later on this day, in the same room, There will be also another couple of discussions and speeches about platform markets. In the Netherlands, we went on the platform Wehkamp. And Wehkamp is one of the leading platforms in the Netherlands. And we foremost went with our clothing on those platforms. And here you see the page of Wehkamp. And the good thing is, so far, we see it as a really a complementary customer journey. So it's not jeopardizing our current business. Even when we were heavily into a promotion campaign in the Netherlands, you saw hardly anything happening on the online channel with the HEMA products of Wehkamp. So a goal, so a partnership we try pride, we good and proud on. And this fall, we launch also on in the US on Walmart.com. And in franprix, by the way, we also will be available in L'Appli de BB. So that's a pick and store concept where it has been delivered at home. So we combine the food deliveries with HEMA deliveries, all driven from franprix themselves. Then the last business model first is partnerships. And that is more of a container topic, where we just try, mostly in our home countries, to come up with partnerships, saving economies, using similar buying sources to save costs, things like that. So to get all this started, it's nice to come up with four new business models, but really, HEMA, as a company, needed to change as well. You should imagine that HEMA had never sent before an invoice to somebody. All our products went just running through our tails. And yeah, that's something you have to set up. There's no account management. Nobody had ever a customer. No, no customer, that is a consumer. Trade marketing skills, we're not there. So we had to change. So we hired new people with new skill sets. And we were embedding a new value for the total company, which is act as an entrepreneur. Very much matching also our new owner, which loves to drive the top line growth. And we work now also with new business teams to get the new partners operational quickly. And those are agile project teams with innovation labs to get quickly up to speed with the epics and the topics that they're facing. So this resulted in, for example, that a project like franprix was launched in just 3 months after the first introduction meeting we had with franprix. It's a nice journey, I have to say, for me and for HEMA. And this is the journey of HEMA till date. We continue our travels. And I really believe the sky is the limit. There's way more partnerships and combinations possible for a retailer to evolve into a global brand. So now over to you. Retail is at a crossroad. What is your journey that you start in order to not end up in my slide here? That's basically it. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivier. It's a very exciting journey indeed. Je ne sais pas si vous avez des questions pour Olivier. If you have any questions for Olivier, feel free. We have some mics. On a des micros mains. Olivier, you can also answer in French a little bit because
you're fun.
Le français n'est pas mal.
Oui, je vais essayer.
Si vous avez des questions, n'hésitez pas. Ou alors, sinon, ah oui, on a des questions là. On va vous passer le micro.
On a besoin de l'ami. Ah, okay.
Hi, Oliver. I'd like to know what's your main pitfall when you've been trying to enter the French market. I mean, how do you compare the French market versus the Dutch market, for example?
Okay, the challenges to penetrate the French market compared to the Dutch market.
Well, the big difference is that we have a really long heritage in the Netherlands, really playing all categories, strong in food, strong in clothing. And the focus in France is mostly has been on Paris, where we have over 34 stores. And we started also with an advantage, because the stores are relatively young and new. If you end up in a HEMA store, There's young people, the music is on, it's vibrant, and we have a slightly smaller selection of products. But the approach is that we really would like to also become a global brand in France. So we want to also cover the rest of France, go on platforms when the time is right, and especially now do our thing with franprix and expand with them and maybe also with the other group that they belong to in other parts. So we really would like to create the omnichannel, and so it is a bit different, but I think the fastness is an advantage. We can go here quicker maybe than in the Netherlands.
Thank you. Yeah? We have another question.
Hello.
Hi.
The question would be, how do you balance your trade within different channel? Meaning, do you target different type of customer? Do you place different type of products? How don't you get too much overlapping?
I think it's a good question, and I hope I will go in the direction that you also feel free. Otherwise, tell me differently. I think we do not target a different customer. We stay close to our values, what we want to offer. So it's for the average wallet to bring a bit more fun in their daily life. And those people in Paris shop for the wider assortment. So we have like 20,000 SKUs in a normal retail store in HEMA, France. But they also do the daily shopping. And when you come across some convenient shopping where you have a party, I think it's the same consumer that you offer affordable products. Obviously, there's differences. There's a slightly different consumer profile of franprix versus HEMA. HEMA is a bit younger. We do not say, hey, we have different positioning for HEMA consumers in franprix versus in HEMA. And we also won't do in the omnichannel.
Thank you. Merci beaucoup. Thank you, Olivier. Well done. Thank you very much. Merci.